Welcome to episode 4 of Motor City Music Society. My name is Erin.
And I'm Tammy.
And we're going to get this party started right now.
I'm so excited.
Well, this is, like I said, episode 4, Motor City Music Society. My name is Erin.
I'm Tammy, and we are live here with Core Effect in studio, in Sound Chef studio here.
Yes.
Very excited.
Say hi, guys.
Hi.
Hello.
They're like, oh, hey. Hey, what's up? It's time to talk now. You guys were so talkative before we were live, and now you're like, shh. It's all good. So you can find Motor City Music Society in a few different places online if you want to follow us while we're not live every other Monday. And we are on both, well, if you are watching right now, you're on Facebook, but we are also on Twitter and Snapchat at MC Music Society, and also Instagram at Motor City Music Society. You can follow me, Erin, at Elsie Binks everywhere online. And Tammy,
I'm at facebook.com/rainbow with 3 A's, so it's RAAAINBOW.
Yeah.
W.
I like that.
I say W.
There's a lot of W's.
Right. Yes.
Yes. All right. And Core Effect. I know CoreEffect.com is kind of your main hub. I don't know if you guys want to specifically use any of them more than any of the other social medias.
Oh, they're all great.
We got Spotify and stuff like that, YouTube, whatever.
Everywhere.
And I know you guys have a lot of people that follow you, but if you don't mind, could you introduce yourselves individually so that there's new time people that haven't seen you yet? Love to know your names and stuff.
I'm John.
I'm Randy.
I'm Joe.
I'm Mathir in the back.
In the back.
Nice, on the drums.
In the back, depending on what camera you're in, you know, depending. Yeah, so before we really get the show started, we have our very first sponsor.
That's great.
Our very first sponsor, and our own AaronG made an in-house ad for them. It is College Dolls with Cleaning Tiles, and we're going to hear from them right now.
You want it clean? We're on the scene. College Dolls with Cleaning Towels provides dependable, on-time, likable, and loyal service. We provide you with a customized cleaning solution to fit your needs. Basic or deep cleaning, move-in or move-out cleaning, post-construction cleanup, homes, apartments, businesses, special events, and more. Our attention to detail is second to none, and we provide you with a cleaner, healthier, and happier environment. We are licensed, bonded, and insured, serving southeastern Michigan. Call now at 586-981-0814 or collegedollswithcleaningtowels.com. You want it clean? We're on the scene.
And I think it's pretty important that we say something about sponsorships right now. That was our very first sponsorship opportunity that we just played.
I loved it because I love clean stuff.
I know, right?
Can I just jump in and add that was done right here at the sound
show? It was. And that voice that you're hearing right now, who you probably can't see at the moment, is Kevin. Kevin Wesley Williams is one of the engineers and producers here at the Sound Shop in Macomb. And we have lots of people who like to talk during this show, and only like half of us are on screen, but we also have AaronG TV, who you just heard in that commercial.
Hello, everybody.
And he's running the HD cams for the music videos that appear on our YouTube channels later.
Very nice.
Yes, he's the one running those HD cams.
They're probably going to change your life.
They do. Know, they're life-changing. I totally agree.
He's totally life-changing. I mean, he does the voiceovers for Hungry Howie's.
Yeah, hungry.
Hungry. Howie's. Pizza. Yeah.
I know. That's another sponsor.
You can't do that because if they're not paying and we're not
stop
doing
stop plugging Howie's.
I'm not. Okay, here comes pizza already.
No more. I know. No
yeah,
more.
If you want to start Hungry Howie's, if you want to start providing pizza.
I know, right?
For the Motor City Music Society Monday nights, we would welcome that. We might even give you another plug.
We always like talk about food on the show.
Yes.
I think it's just because by the time the show actually airs, we're so hungry.
I'm starving.
We'd rather have Jets.
Oh, let's get Jets. I'm okay with that,
goodness.
Too. I'm okay with
but
that,
Hungry
too.
Hungry Howie's pay some of our bills around here.
And so just in case any of the any of those sponsorship opportunities are listening, we do have a package system plan. Me and Tammy sat down and kind of put a plan together. And there are three platforms to listen/watch to this to this podcast, this podcast. Mm-hmm. And so there's Facebook, YouTube, and iTunes. And all three packages are 3 months in advance. So you'd get 3 months worth of shows, which is six episodes, seven, depending on if there's like 5 weeks in a month or something dumb like that, you know, calendars. And so depending on the month, it's 3 months. And the first package is $150. The second package is $240. And the third package is $280, I believe. And every single package that goes up, you get another platform provided to you to advertise on. So I think that's pretty cool. I don't remember exactly how it builds up. I think Facebook is the first one.
Yeah.
And then the Facebook. And anyway, well, if you're interested, you can
We'd love to advertise for you. We're going to do you good.
Yes. You can message me or Tammy or Erin or Kevin or Phil or anybody involved with the project. Or you can email MotorCityMusicSociety@gmail.com for more information. I check that email myself so I can get sponsorship pricing packages to you if you would like to do that.
All right.
And so,
I'm thinking.
Oh, no, go ahead.
No, I just want to talk about your guys's real quick.
Yeah, we can get to them.
Flip over. I just wanted to ask you guys about your upcoming projects and shows that you have coming up. Like I said.
What would you like to know?
Well, when are you playing next? How about that?
We're playing the Shelter, like you said.
Yes, the Shelter. 26th. Yes.
It's a Sunday. Nice. Sold out.
Sold out
so, already?
Yeah.
But, that is great.
Well, so when it is the 20th.
Yeah, it wasn't our fault that it sold out.
No, that's amazing. And I've seen your guys' videos, and I think you're really good. So I can realize why it sold out. Is there another show after that you have planned that people could get tickets to
There's
now?
There's a couple that are working up. I don't know if anything's in stone yet. But.
Okay, so they can always check that out on your website, right?
Yep.
Okay.
CoreEffect.com, of course.
Yes, CoreEffect.com.
And the reason it sold out is because...
Of us. Oh.
Well, awesome. Yeah, go ahead, Randy.
We're opening for a band called Big Wreck.
Yes.
They're a Canadian band. They're really, really good. And they get a lot of Canadian followers, so should be a good time.
Yeah, Kevin turned me on to them when Elsie Binks took a road trip down to Philadelphia this past summer. And we listened to them like part of the way, you know, it was like an 8 or 9 hour drive or something. And Kevin like took me and Phil hostage and we were just listening to Big Wreck for like half a day. You know, I say that, but you know.
Another use for
duct
tape.
We enjoyed it.
It was basically a 9 hour education in Big Wreck. And when we got done, we went back to the top again and then we reviewed again from the first record on up. And then when we got done, we reviewed again. So there was a lot of reviewing going on.
Which is totally fine. And I just realized I didn't actually introduce Phil, who is an important part of this
very
stream as well. He's actually the person that clicks go on the stream, if you will. He's
and
sitting behind
more.
Me. You can't see him in the camera, but his name is Phil Steuer. He's in my band, and he also runs the part of the technical, all of this mumbo jumbo for the podcast. He's just the one switching the cameras and helping AaronG set up these cameras.
Awesome guy.
And all sorts of stuff going on, and he's the one recording the audio. There's just a whole lot going on. And so
vital to the process.
It's vital. Yes. Vital. I think you should always talk in a British accent.
Yes, please.
There's
all the
so
time.
Many accents we've got yet to hear from AaronG.
I know.
I'm so excited.
I know. And so I did want to ask you guys one question before we hear some of your music. I've been listening to your music, most recently the Ethos, your most recent album that came out in 2015. Came out in 2015. We're in BC ages right now. Came out in 2015. And I understand why you guys call yourself modern rock, but I would kind of like you to explain to the listeners where your influences come from and why you call yourselves modern rock.
Well, modern rock because we're just trying to think of something new sounding.
Mm-hmm.
So if it just feels new and fresh, then I just said, you know, use the word modern because hopefully it's something that nobody really has heard that exact style yet, you know? So the new songs are like a big throw from our last album.
Oh, really?
And the last album was a big throw from the one before that I did 2008. So it just changes big time. You know,
yeah.
Different band. You know, the next album is like a different band.
Yeah, and I haven't had a chance to look at your backlog, which is massive. You have a 7-album backlog. And so it's overwhelming. I went to go do my research on you guys, and I was like, holy hell, I don't have time to listen to all this music.
Well, there's 2 albums you should listen to.
There's two albums we should listen to.
Two.
The Ethos and the Armored Shades of Light. That's everybody.
Ethos and Armored Shades of Light.
Yeah.
That's good to know. That's good for the people to know. If you like what you're about to hear on Motor City Music Society, then you're going to want to check out those two albums. That's important. And like I said, the one I was listening to is Ethos, and I love it. And we're going to hear one song from that tonight. And the other three are brand spanking new. So are you guys working on a new album right now?
Yeah, we're just trying to put one together.
Mm-hmm. That's awesome.
And the first song you are actually playing is a working title. It's a new song, so it's pretty much unheard, and it's called Need You Babe.
Yeah.
I'm really excited to hear that song.
And I think, you know what? I think this is going so well, I kind of just want to hear it. Are you guys ready for your first song this evening?
Sure. I'm so pumped.
Very good. AaronG, are you ready on the HD cameras?
I am ready.
Watches.
So for the first time this evening, you're going to hear from Core Effect, and this one's called Need You Babe. And I think... also, it's important to say need like a cat is kneading on somebody.
Yes, or you K-N-E-E-D or you need is it dough. Spelled here.
It's K-N-E-E-D you, babe.
So is this like a massage? Well, we'll find out if
we're
it's
a massage. We're
going to find out. Yeah, we'll listen to the lyrics. Part.
Need.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, need. Like, I need you in the... Okay.
Oh.
Okay.
And yeah, and now I get it. I'm thinking a massage because I'm a girl, but need you in the... Yeah.
There you go. Mm. Multiple meanings. Whenever you guys are ready.
I could say balls.
I could say these nuts.
You play tonight. I feel insane tonight. I'm here to make it right. I feel the same. I love you. I can't believe what I'm thinking, but I love you. You didn't see it coming, and you could keep running, but you never get away with my love. You won't see nothing, never get away from my gun. So, no, no, no. Well, I need you here tonight. I need to quit tonight. I'm here to make it right. I'm here to say goodnight. I can't believe what I'm thinking. I love you. Keep in mind that you didn't see it coming, and you can keep running, but you'll never get away with my love. Won't see nothing, never get away from my gun. So, oh no, no. Tonight, I'm here to make it right. You love me.
And that was Need You Now. We are Motor City Music Society. I am Tammy. This is Erin. And we are here with Core Effect. And that was the first song they played for us tonight.
I believe it was called Need You Babe.
Need You Babe.
That's
sorry.
That's a good one. It's okay.
Need You Now. It reminds me.
Need You Now is, I think, is Lady Antebellum.
I was looking at this and looking at that. Sorry about that. So that is
fair.
Called Need You Babe. Need You Babe. And I'm looking also at a lot of viewers are watching right now. And I have some viewer questions for you guys. One of them being from Karen Zadie. She wants to know, how long have you guys been playing together? And she keeps trying to ask. She wants to know the question. I seen that you guys started in 2005. So could you tell us how long you guys have been together as a group?
I think it was 2004. I think Joe and I started playing together.
Yeah. And then we've had some different members in the band. I think Athir joined in about 2008 or 2009.
Yeah, nine. I joined in 2007 or eight. And then I was out of the band for a couple of years. And then about 4 or 5 years ago, I joined back up.
Nice. And I know that you guys have played with a lot of bands. Can you tell the viewers that haven't seen you before what bands you have played with before? I know Candlebox was one of them at Stars and Stripes. Was it 2015 or 13?
We played with Candlebox last year, too.
Okay.
St. Clair
That's
River
awesome.
Fest.
Oh, yeah, St. Clair River Fest. Love that.
The
definitely.
Best one was with Seether.
Mm-hmm.
2009.
At the Fillmore.
At the Fillmore. That was your favorite show?
It probably
was. So far.
Maybe not the best feeling show, but it was like the biggest show we've ever done.
Wow. Yeah, I bet.
I think they flew me in from Philadelphia to mix that, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, sounds about right.
That's crazy that you weren't here in Michigan, Kev. It's so strange.
They used to fly me in.
Nice.
Glad we got you around here now.
Pretty badass.
They sent Core Force One to get me.
Core Force One.
Core Force.
I guess
instead
that brings
Air Force.
That brings me to a question because for those of you who don't necessarily know the relationship between Kevin and Core Effect, I guess they have a relationship. It's not like random that Core Effect is here. So I need it explained to me like how you guys know each other because he used to live in Philly. For ages. He lived everywhere for ages, but you guys are here. You always been here in Michigan?
Yeah, we've always been here, but Kevin lived here, and then he moved to Philadelphia, 2006 or something? And then we just kept recording. We liked recording with them, and we kept recording and recording and recording and maintained a friendship, and he knows us as well as anybody, so...
Mm-hmm. So did you record, I guess I'm still confused. Maybe I'm just not putting the right dots together. How did you record with him when he moved away?
We went to Philadelphia.
Oh, you literally just left and went to Philly.
And then I would come here as well.
Okay.
We've recorded everywhere. We recorded at the Gospel Music Hall of Fame.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Good engineers.
Thank you guys mesh well because he's that good and you guys are that good from everything I've seen. Loving it.
Yeah, we would go up to the mountains of the Poconos and spend a few weeks recording.
Oh, yeah.
This.
Okay, I didn't realize that was
Core
Effect.
We'd go way up the mountain, like 45 minutes from the nearest town.
That was fun.
And hunker down in this studio that had an apartment attached to it. And we would just make music like 24-7.
There's no reception.
Is it that one picture you have, Kevin, with your hair like
that
a hot mess?
Yeah, probably.
Do you know what picture I'm talking about?
Yeah,
I haven't seen that picture yet, but I'd love to see it after.
I'm gonna have to find
show.
It and post it on our page.
Do you find that going places like that and getting out into you said it's kind of secluded where it was, Kevin, right?
Yeah, I mean, of course, it's great when you can just eliminate everybody. Unfortunately, like it's not a bad thing, but no girlfriends, no wives, no boss, no friends, no distractions.
How
Plus,
many
being
miles
in the
up
nature,
the
right? Being up
it's,
in the nature is probably inspiring.
I mean, it was like a half hour, 40 minutes up that mountain.
Up the mountain, yeah.
Up the mountain.
You wouldn't think a mountain would be that tall, but it takes a long time to get
on a
from
sled.
The bottom
mm-hmm. to the
where the grocery store is.
Oh, yeah.
We had to take a sled.
That's what I was just going to ask you. How did you climb the mountain or did you?
Just like you'd imagine. There's rivers, streams, woods.
That sounds
bears,
it sounds amazing.
But there's roads, though.
Yeah,
bears
there was
don't
bears.
Sound so
imagine
good.
A mule, up the side of a cliff. No,
do you drive up the mountain or I'm just.
Yeah, you drive.
Oh, okay. I see. I didn't know if you were climbing or like.
You drive.
No, that'd be crazy. Like bring all your guitars like they're strapped to your back, just like rock climbing.
We installed the core tram. We take the tram from the bottom to the top now.
Or they have those lifts, too. So that's what I was wondering. Maybe I'm just a little naive about mountains.
Zip
I've never seen one.
I've only been up one mountain, and it was in California. So I'm not familiar with like Philadelphia mountains. I think the only one I've been up was Mulholland Drive. went all the way up to the top of the mountain and came back down. It was very stressful. So I don't want to do that again. Unless it's to stay there for like 5 days and record like you guys did. But yeah. I just did it for the hell of it while I was in California. It was awful.
I've been sledding once. It's a tall hill.
Cool story, bro.
Yeah. Right, bro? Dude.
Dude, hey, bro.
Corfect also recorded at Sigma Studios in Philadelphia, which was like, you can Google Sigma Studios and see all the hits that were recorded up in that place.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
We spent a couple of days in there. We actually slept in the building for a few nights. It was kind of trippy.
Ooh.
That is trippy.
We recorded Armored Shades of Light at the White Room. I think is no longer, right?
And the White Room is no longer. Kid Rock did his first record there, right?
That's in Detroit. He did like part of The Devil Without a Cause.
Oh, damn.
That place was haunted like crazy.
Ew,
that place was freaky. It was one of those elevators when you get into it and you got to close it and then dial the handle to get up. And there was nobody else in this entire building except the White Room Studios. It was completely vacant. It was in the middle of winter. Cold as shit.
Right by the Coney stop, though. It was pretty good.
I'm good with you.
That's really... I'm sorry. I needed sound effects.
Well,
and I want to believe the desk was a Helios desk, which I think rumor had it was Jimi Hendrix recorded on it.
Oh,
that's really sweet.
Yeah.
That is really sweet.
That was pretty fun.
That's badass.
It really is.
I haven't gotten to record in many studios myself, but I have... I want all the stories that you guys must have. Like, seriously, though. Like,
especially the freaky ones.
What's the craziest shit? Like,
that happened.
Yeah,
right?
Like, this needs to continue. Like,
yes,
the craziest
please.
Shit that's happened when you guys have recorded.
The craziest shit?
Yes.
Probably somebody getting into a fight or something like that.
What would the fight have even been about?
It was just music, you know.
Well, that's fair. Recording.
Everybody's going at it, and then, you know.
It's a very passionate thing.
It is.
Yeah.
Absolutely. When there's so many people, I'm in a band myself and I understand completely.
Yeah.
There's different creative
flows.
Yeah, Erin,
they only have four people.
I know.
We have twice as many.
I know.
Band, so
we don't really write in the studio, so it's rare that you actually come up with something great in the studio.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, overdubbing you do, but.
Right.
Because
you have ideas.
I mean, when you play back and it sounds really great, then you're like, wow, that's crazy. That's
mm-hmm.
a good crazy thing.
Then for me, like, my biggest thing, like, I write the music, but I also don't know the harmonies until I'm, like, in it. And I'm like, okay, I know there's a harmony here. And I know there's a harmony here. I just got to put them down now. And then I'm like, wait, there's, like, 8 more harmonies on this that I didn't hear before. So then there's, like, 16 vocal tracks on every single one of my songs. It's obnoxious. I've probably tried to put vocal tracks on your songs. Kevin's always trying to pimp me out. I probably didn't, but... He's not listening at the moment.
Well,
I don't know.
You have an idea when
you're listening
to the studio, and then just something will come to you.
Mm-hmm. I know. It's awesome.
I'm wondering how often you guys practice, because I know you were saying a joke earlier, once every 3 months. You're kidding. But how often do you guys really practice?
We try to once a week,
mm-hmm.
but, you know,
nice.
Someone gets sick, then it turns into 2 weeks,
mm-hmm.
or, you know.
Right.
You know.
Yeah, schedules get crazy. That happens to me in my band, too.
It should be twice a week. You know, there's a lot of bands out there that play every day.
Mm-hmm.
I think when we started out, we used to play like 3-4 times a week.
It's a lot.
It's, yeah. We got things down pretty well now. It's just trying to write, find time to write and all that. It takes a lot of work.
Mm-hmm. Me and Randy have bigger families now than we did back then. We were just by ourselves, you know.
Are you both married with kids or with kids?
I have a girlfriend.
Yeah, family men. Got it. So it does sometimes you have to make sure to have the balance in there. Do you hang out together as a group or meet up? Do you have any favorite restaurants or hangout spots that you guys would meet up at?
Well, I moved far away, so.
You did.
He lives in Brighton.
Brighton,
oh, yeah.
Okay. I used to live on that side of town myself.
So, yeah.
They don't have restaurants in Brighton.
No,
it's just rocks and sticks and golfers.
No, I like Brighton.
Bread and water.
No, it's pretty cool. Like, what do you do in Brighton, then?
What do I do? Just go home and sleep and play with my kids and...
Do you watch any TV shows currently? Are there any TV shows that you're watching? Is that something you do?
But sometimes, yeah. True Detective. That's a good one.
Yeah.
True Detective.
I loved season one of True Detective until the very last episode, and I was like, fuck you.
I got so upset.
Two seasons.
I know. I didn't even give second season a try because I hated the ending of the first season so much. I'm very judgmental. Sorry.
No, you're. That's good. I mean, do you guys actually? Do you watch? Do you wait to watch the show live, or are you watching it like on Netflix or pre-recorded? How do you watch TV?
Yeah, it's got to be pre-recorded.
Yeah,
commercials suck.
I believe what I watch is always pre-recorded. It's porn, so I'm not sure how they do it live.
I meant, yeah, definitely. I meant, like, do you record the shows and save them up and go on a binge, like an eating binge, like a TV binge, or do you watch them, do you wait for them?
Well, time is valuable.
So, one at a time?
He doesn't watch much TV, but
you.
I just sit down and I flip on the guide. I'm old-fashioned style. I don't.
You just
like
watch
to sit and think of what I have to watch. I like to just pop it on and, oh, there that is, or whatever.
Definitely.
He likes his Amazon stick.
The Fire Stick. I heard about that. Nice.
And I don't know what Joe does. What do
you do
Joe?
Over there,
I
Joe?
I don't even have a TV. So.
You don't have
TV? Joe sold his TV.
Yeah, sold my TV. So.
No shit.
Kind of like me. If I didn't even notice the TV was there, I wouldn't turn it on. I'd pick a book up.
Oh, I'm good for you.
I'm not trying to brag.
I never read.
Kind of nerdy.
I listen to books, though. I drive so much that I have to listen to books to consume them. I don't have time to, like, pick up. I mean, if I didn't watch TV, I would have time to read.
To do it, yeah.
I just prioritize poorly.
Yeah.
I will sit down and watch a whole season of a show.
Certain ones I will.
If I have a day to do nothing, you better believe I'm going to pick a show on Netflix and that first season will be watched.
Well, what are you watching now?
Everything.
Everything.
That I'm supposed to be watching.
Oh, that's good.
Like a good TV consumer. Mm. I'm just kidding. That just makes me have no life, really. No, it's really just Netflix. Netflix has caused so many problems. Like, I just watch so much Netflix. Like, you guys apparently are
Josh,
like, no,
said
we
today
do not
he's been
Netflix.
Binging on Netflix. He's been sick the last couple of days.
Oh, well, that's it's the
he's
good.
Like, do you have Netflix? I'm like, no. He goes, dude, I'm addicted.
Yeah. Dude, there's everything in the world to watch on it. There's so many good shows. Like, there's so
and
many
documentaries,
shows.
Right?
I love documentaries.
Was that my cue? Documentaries.
That was your cue because that's your
because it looks like you're taking a documentary
voice,
right
yes.
now.
Yeah, right here. We are in the studio. We notice that Core Effect suddenly realize that they do not take in entertainment. Their lives were only about music.
We need a movie trailer for this.
Dude, you got the
blend
best
music.
Voice.
Doesn't he? He's got the best voice.
I hear the second guitarist actually sold his television to pursue
his
music more intensely.
Now that's passion.
It seriously
the
is.
The drummer though. Only took in live shows.
I don't know if you have another. I have another question.
Yeah,
it's a
go.
Little bit that. I wanted to ask each of you guys this one. Name three important things that money can't buy.
Hey.
Can I start with you?
Money can't
Randy?
Buy.
Three important things that money can't buy.
Oh, my family. It can't buy a good song. And it can't buy happiness.
Yes. Over to you.
I'm going to say money can't buy me love.
Yeah.
That's a good song.
I know you guys love the Beatles, number one.
Yeah. It can't buy you a good song idea. Good one, Randy.
That was so passive aggressive.
Money can't buy my daughter Layla enough things.
Oh,
how sweet!
Just melted all of
women's
ovaries listening.
Yeah. Hi, sweetie pie.
Is that what that sound was?
Hi, Layla. Hi, beautiful. We're going to go over there.
Oh,
to Joe?
To Joe, yes.
Nailed them all, though. I mean, happiness,
yeah, bring
love,
your mic up.
And, sorry, happiness, love, and a good song. Those three.
Good song.
They already nailed them.
Way to think of your own
Does
ideas.
Does Athir have anything new to say? He's like, I don't know.
Yeah,
I would say family for sure, but, you know, you can't buy friends, money, and just peace of mind. I mean, there's no price on that, you know.
It's priceless. All those things are priceless.
Mhm.
So good to hear.
It is.
Absolutely.
It is. I don't think I have anything to add either. That's so.
I think money can't buy you time.
I think maybe
time. Nobody said time.
Time's a good one.
A race against the clock.
It is. It's all
there comes a point where it doesn't matter how much money you make.
It does.
Everybody is fighting against time.
It is. So health would be one of them.
Morgan.
Yeah.
Dude.
I know.
And do you get one?
No, actually, I was going to say we should probably do another song.
Okay, I'm thinking that too. Because I'm excited
for
the new song. You want to announce the new song?
Sure.
It is a new song.
It is a new song. It is called Time for Living, as I've been told. It is called Time for Living. And yeah, whenever you guys are ready, go ahead and play.
Take it down.
Say give it up for Core Effect. There's nobody here to clap, but I'm clapping.
I loved it.
That was Core Effect with Time for Living. I really like that one. It reminds me, there's a song it reminds me of, and I can't quite place it.
Don't go there.
No, you're like, shit. No, I can't quite place it, but I love it. It's so what I listen to typically. I love it so very much.
Thank you.
So yeah. So coming up in this segment, as I call it, so this is where I like to play a game with you guys, and it's actually kind of modeled after that game that you probably know. It's called Fuck, Marry, Kill, where you have three options and you have to choose one for each one. It's modeled after that. It's not that. Don't worry. It's not that.
Fuck you. Can't go ahead.
Marry, Kill, apparently.
It is not that.
Never played that one.
It's called.
Born in the 80s.
Never met
that.
Really?
Yeah.
She was born in the 80s, too.
I know. Actually, I was born in the 70s.
Okay, fair, but you still knew what it was.
Jerk.
Yes.
Jerk.
She has a television.
I was born at the end of the 70s.
Okay.
Very tip.
Shh. Edit this out. No, I'm kidding. I
was born in the 80s also.
I'm 37.
FYI. I was also born in the 80s, so I'm glad you think I wasn't, though.
88.
Well, here's a fun fact. Today's my birthday.
Hey!
Oh, my God.
Birthday.
Happy birthday,
about Athir's birthday.
Hey, dude. Happy birthday, bro.
Happy birthday, Athir. Oh,
yeah. 33.
You're 33
good.
Today,
feels
celebrating
good.
For
feels
the 18th
good.
Time. Feels I'm just
really
kidding.
33 sounds like a good number. Yes.
Yeah.
So what are you doing to celebrate?
Fucking playing music.
Hell yeah.
Mostly.
Right.
Hell yeah.
Birthday podcast.
I'm playing some good music
right
at
now.
That. Yeah.
Birthday podcast. And so, you know what? I think because it's your birthday, I want you to answer this first, Athir.
Okay.
So we're going to play a game kind of like Fuck, Marry, Kill. Not quite that. It's called Drink, Play, Dress, where I'm going to give you three options, and it's within your influences. So it's going to be three musicians, or bands in this case, three bands. And you can choose to have a drink with one of them, play a show with one of them, or switch wardrobes with one of them. And so...
All right.
And I want to know why also when you give your answers.
I don't know about it.
So,
okay.
You have the three bands, the Beatles, Metallica, and Pearl Jam. You can switch wardrobes with, play a show with, or have a drink with.
Switch wardrobes with the Beatles.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
That's a good one.
Sorry, I got excited.
I know.
What was it? Play a show with?
Play a show with and have a drink with.
Play a show with
Metallica.
Metallica.
Oh, yeah, awesome.
And have a drink with Led Zeppelin.
Or Pearl Jam.
Pearl Jam.
Is what I said.
Why Pearl Jam?
Pearl Jam was in there.
Because that's what I said.
I thought you said my influences.
Oh, no. Those were. So that was the list of So the list of influences John gave me, I gave you three of them. But Zeppelin's great. See, if Led Zeppelin were in this, I would have answered that to all
three
of them.
Still, though, I mean, if you had to just have a drink with somebody, wouldn't it be Pearl Jam? Because you'd rather do the show with Metallica.
Yeah.
And you'd still rather wear the Beatles clothes.
Yeah.
So you're still good.
So that's still fair.
Yeah, yeah.
That's still
fair. Have a drink with Pearl Jam.
Totally.
I've met Lars, so I'm not going to have a drink with him.
Really?
Beatles, I haven't.
Lars is pounding his fist on the table now.
That's what was it like to meet him?
I was about 14, and I went to their hotel where they were staying at, and I had an older friend of mine get a hotel for me and my buddies, and he was in the bar. So it was like an open bar in Troy. There was a hotel called Embassy Suites.
Huh.
So it was kind of like an atrium thing. So we looked down from our floor. We could see him at the bar party, and the bar was open. So you could just go in there. There wasn't like there wasn't a door guy. It's just an open bar.
Wow.
When he was sitting next to the guitar player from the Cult, I forgot his name, but tapped on his shoulder, and he didn't turn around. I tapped on his shoulder again, and he didn't turn around. I'm like, what the fuck is... I looked at my buddy. I'm like, what do I do? And finally, I tap the third time, and he turns around. He's like, what? Like, really loud to scare the fuck out of me. He's like, I'm just fucking with you. And then he just took pictures with it. He was really cool.
That's
then
awesome.
Later that evening, someone pulled his pants down. He was standing there naked.
Oh, dear.
In the middle of the bar.
Wow. Well, I'm so glad I mentioned.
All that fun stuff comes after midnight.
Yeah, that's true.
It was way after midnight, yeah.
All the fun stuff.
And you were only 14.
I was 14, and I was like, what the fuck? This is what I want to do. Yeah.
That's an insane. I'm so glad we mentioned Metallica.
Yeah.
Definitely.
And got that story out of it, especially for like a birthday story. Does anybody else want to answer the question? It can be any of your influences, I suppose.
It's the same exact thing. I like his answer.
Yeah. You could pick different bands. I mean, it's our show. Shit.
Randy wants to play with Pearl Jam. He wants to answer it. Go ahead,
Pearl
Randy.
Jam's
yeah, go ahead.
No, I'd probably play with Pearl. I'd drink with Queens of the Stone. No, I'd play with Queens of the Stone Age.
Yeah, okay.
But that wasn't the question.
I know.
That's okay. You can answer however you want to.
The rules.
You should hear how Kevin answers these questions.
Yeah, I already have my answer.
I'm sure I can't wait.
Just like the Beatles because of Sgt. Pepper's.
Yes. Yes.
Those are sweet. And what was the other one? Drink with Pearl Jam. Yep.
That's awesome. I don't know how. I would have to think about how I'd answer this, actually.
Well, I'm not sure about the third, but I would love to either do a show dressed as Metallica with the Beatles.
Oh, my gosh.
Dress like the Beatles and do a show with Metallica.
Okay. Okay.
Kevin, what's your answer?
You know Kevin's answer.
I don't know.
I know Kevin's answer.
I know Kevin's answer already.
I'm predicting. I'm psychic, by the way.
I would definitely switch wardrobe with the Beatles, and I would most definitely love to play a show with the Beatles, and I would definitely drink with any Beatle anywhere, anytime.
I knew it.
There you go.
I told you I'm psychic. I'll tell you my services later. I'll tell you my number.
You must be psychic.
And Kevin, this literally every time we play this game, Kevin has one band for all three answers. He just ignores the rules entirely. And just in case you guys are just now seeing what's happened, it is Athira's birthday, and there is a cake
to you.
Oh, we're singing.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
Oh, yes, President. Whoa. Gotta love it.
Surprise birthday cake.
I like
in
the
studio.
Cake. So we got four candles on that cake.
Four.
You got lucky.
I know.
Had you have had to blow out the whole full 33, do you think you could have?
Fuck no. Getting
over
fucking.
No.
Something would have been on fire here.
You even turned the lights out.
That was so cute.
I know. Yeah. That was the band's idea, and we were sworn to secrecy so that way Athir wouldn't know that that there was a cake coming his way. So nobody's like cool enough to be here to also eat cake, so we're just going to have a cake party.
Heck yeah.
Can we smash it in each other's face?
No.
Please.
Only just standing on plastic.
Right. We need to create a Dexter room before we have a cake fight. Just like
plastic. With the tarp. Yeah.
every single time.
Not the killing part, though, right?
No, not the killing part. I mean, we can kill
not.
The cake.
No. Yeah.
Kill that cake.
Kill that cake.
Kill that.
What kind of cake was it, or is it, guys? Do you know?
I think it's a Kroger whipped topping marble cake.
Oh my God!
Yes,
it's a registered trademark of Kroger,
aka the best cake ever.
I was gonna say yes. Marble cake is
down with that. No
awesome.
Nuts, right?
The best
it's like
of both.
Multicultural.
No
cool.
It's
multicultural. So when we after every episode, we take a selfie with the band because that's like the thumbnail of the video. We have to get the cake in the selfie. So we can like mark this experience as this is like the first birthday episode.
It is.
We haven't had a band, anybody on who's had a birthday on the episode. I mean, granted, this is the fourth episode. But hey, it could have happened already and it hasn't. So I'm super excited about it. I don't see nothing wrong with
that. It's excitement worthy. No,
I know.
I'm with you.
I know. And with that, I think I want to hear another song. Are you guys cool with that?
Yeah.
We're running right on time and it's very cool. It's making me very happy.
Great.
We're running right down with my rundown.
All the OCD watches right now.
I know. Nobody knows. I mean, I plan this out to the minute on my paper, and we're going right with it right now, and it makes me very happy. So this next song you guys are going to hear is called Level, and it's on their 2015 record called Ethos. So you can actually check this one out on iTunes if you'd like to, but I suggest you listen live right now.
Go, 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 go. Leave to the window, here we go.
Follow you.
loved it. That was Level from Ethos, your guys' album Ethos. And that was great.
How'd
you feel about it? Are you live?
I was Snapchatting.
Oh, you're Snapchat. I'm Snapchat guilty. Okay.
I just like Snapchat. Don't mind me over here.
No, I like it. I got a question for each of you guys. I think I'm going to start off with John. You ready?
It's a good way to start.
Okay, kind of, would you rather? Would you rather have no socks or no underwear for 1 month? So basically, you can't wear socks for a month, or you can't. You have to free ball for a month. So what would you rather do?
I love that you just said free ball.
Well, I mean, you cuss.
I would definitely just free ball it for a month for sure.
Because socks are important, right?
Wait. Did you say sex or socks?
Socks.
Did you think you said socks? Yeah. What are you
socks.
Thinking about right now?
I'm thinking, would you rather not be able to wear socks for a month, or would you rather not
socks
be able to
underwear.
Wear underwear? What's is okay. more important, socks or underwear?
Socks.
I know my.
I was wondering why he
accent.
Took so long to
well,
answer
listen,
that question.
It's my Midwestern accent. That socks sounds like sex with me.
Of time it took, though.
Yeah. You would okay. say almost well, gave up sex over.
This is a clothing like, question. It's my accent here. Okay.
Your Michigan accent.
It's socks or underwear. What's more important
socks
for that month?
Underwear.
You can only have one.
I got to wear my underwear.
Yeah. Important thing. Okay, I get it.
Yeah, I think I'd choose underwear too.
Really?
Yeah, I would. Well, depend. Yeah,
look,
no,
man.
Yeah, I'd choose underwear.
I got you. I do the same. Definitely. Okay. That was
like
that question.
Though. I like that.
Everybody gets their
learning
own question.
A lot of things.
Two questions.
This is the weird question segment, so be prepared.
Yeah, I'm the weirdo. I ask the weird questions. Here.
Or the super awesome
I feel like this
birthday
is one of those
boy.
First dates where they're like, we're going to play 20 questions.
Yeah.
Like, this date is over.
Is the date over already?
No.
It's because you got the cake already.
No.
That's why.
Go ahead.
No, you got the cake, so the date's
I
over.
I got an answer for you.
I got a question for you. Would you rather eat nothing but baked goods like cake for a month, or nothing but seafood? That's all you can have.
Ooh.
Cake, baked goods, or you can just have seafood that whole month.
Being that I'm a diabetic,
oh dear.
I'll take fucking baked goods all over it.
You're gonna
baked
take
goods.
The baked goods
yeah,
because
fuck
you're
yeah.
diabetic?
Yeah, fuck
cake's
yeah.
Cake's gonna kill you.
Yeah,
the level of mercury in that seafood will kill you too.
Question then. That was unfortunate.
Oh my God. We're gonna kill all of our guests.
I would pick seafood all day. I'd eat sushi every day.
I know you would. You love sushi. We've talked about sushi in the past.
I know. It's a problem. Anyway, continue.
Okay, Joe. Would you rather lose your sense of taste or your sense of smell?
I would have to go with sense of smell. I would rather.
Yeah, but
you'd rather lose your sense of smell so you can still taste. So you can still taste. Because why?
Can you lose one without the other though?
I don't think so.
In the magic
world
of question,
the magic land of here.
That's actually impossible because so much of what we do and what we taste is dependent on smell. So the question actually becomes a sort of imaginary thing. Now, personally, I believe.
You're going to confuse the listeners so much.
Your sense of smell could be a superpower.
It could be
a
superpower.
That's not even bad.
You could work
it's like Dewey
sense
Cox.
All day. I lose my sense of smell every time I drive into town. Okay, carry on.
You could work down in the River Rouge area and not bother you if you didn't smell. You work at one of
that's
them.
That's true.
Work at one of them refineries.
Sewage workers. It'd be like perfect. We digress very quickly here.
Randy, did you get your question?
What?
Randy.
No, oh. No, he didn't.
I got Randy's
Randy,
question.
Randy, answer your question.
Socks. Answer your question, Randy. Your question is, would you rather live 100 years in the future or 100 years in the past?
Ooh.
Ooh. No, definitely 100 years in the past. I don't like people now.
They're changing.
It's going to get worse, right?
This man doesn't even own a television. Of course it would be 100 years in the past.
Well, no. Yeah. I mean, I think it's pretty. Like, all the stuff that happened in the last 100 years is just blow your mind.
It's amazing.
People landing on the moon and playing electric guitars and
so much in the past.
I know a lot of more stuff will happen, but people have just become robots and not people anymore. And they just don't value the things that they should.
Didn't you guys used to have a robot in your band once?
Yeah, we had a robot once in our band. It was a horrible experience.
That actually explains it.
You need to talk. You need to talk
in your
mic, Randy.
I'm sorry about my critique of you last.
Yeah, Kev's gonna get angry with you because you're not standing by your mic.
You need to talk in your mic. We can't hear you.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. Really loud for me.
I didn't realize you'd been chased by a robot before. So yeah,
you really performed with a robot, or was it just a metaphorical?
Yeah, we called him the bot. He had no emotion, and he was a robot.
Whoa!
You guys know.
You guys know.
We won't say any names.
He's right.
That's funny.
He can't hear us now.
He's a robot. He's shut his ass off.
I feel like there's so much power going on.
Robin Williams from Bicentennial Man.
Oh,
okay.
No.
I was going to say, what's your favorite robot?
There's a lot of robot movies. There's iRobot. Yeah, Bicentennial Man. What's that?
I would have to say my favorite robot would be the cleaning lady from the Jetsons.
The Terminator.
That would be mine, too. I need that one.
Rosie.
I'm on the same page with you, Kevin.
I like the one from Short Circuit. I forget the name of that one.
Oh, that's awesome. My band anytime.
What?
Isn't it Johnny Five?
Is it Johnny Five?
That's it. Yeah. On the nose.
It must be, because what else would it be?
All right. I know it's Johnny Five. It was my favorite movie when I was a kid.
Okay. I trust you. I trust you. I have that shit on DVD still. I love that movie. It's so good. Short Circuit. Do you have any more questions?
I have one more question, actually.
I know you do.
From a viewer.
Oh, yeah.
Her name's Kay Tennant, and she wants to know. I'll pick one of you at random. I'll pick you. Would you rather perform with Pink or Aerosmith? And this is coming from Kay Tennant.
And who knows why she picked Pink or Aerosmith. I'm not...
This.
I mean, either way.
Aerosmith.
Yep. That's your answer, Kay. Yes. Aerosmith.
Could you play a Pink song with Aerosmith?
Thank you so much, you guys, for watching and submitting your questions that you
did
send
to us.
That
would be awesome. Play a Pink song with Aerosmith.
Aerosmith has a song named Pink.
Right.
Yeah,
and yeah.
I was thinking the same. Yeah, when I heard that.
Pink.
It's apparently
his favorite color.
I don't know the words. That's the only word.
My favorite color.
That's even my favorite.
No, that was Marilyn Manson. That wasn't Aerosmith. Yeah, that
the beautiful great. People. Beautiful people.
We're all stars now.
We're just all
in
stars.
In the dope show.
I know. Oh, gosh.
I'm picking up Erin's accent.
Oh, yes, please.
Yes,
I know.
Please.
We're all going to start talking like we're from the UK. I don't know how it's happening, but it's just
in your mind.
It just slides right in there.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, dear. Really. Oh, dear.
Come off it,
man. And we're
Erin,
back.
I'm rubbing off on you.
And we're back. Do you have any more questions for them?
No, but I actually want to... We're going to be doing the final song. We're going to be coming back with some really fun rapid-fire questions.
Absolutely.
Viewers who are still watching... Boy. If you have any rapid fire questions, I'm going to look down and see. I've got mine all prepared. We're going to be coming
Me
back
too.
With that fun. Right now, they have a brand new song that they're going to be playing for us called Bright Silver Lights. So this is Core Effect once again, and let's hear you guys play. Loving it.
Oh,
amazing. Bright Silver Lights. It's a new song that you guys just started, just came out with. So that is the first time you guys are hearing it tonight.
Yeah.
I really love that one.
I think it's awesome that you guys came with like three brand new songs. So that way people could only listen to it here. As opposed to...
Those are just the most fun, you know, when they're new.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I totally understand. I pretty much call... Even if it's like a year old, I'm like, this is a new song. And I'm like, it's really not. It just feels new still.
Yeah, playing new stuff is like you kind of get to test drive it, mm-hmm. you know,
it's
on different
shows.
It's
new to you. We've been driving that car for a year.
Yep.
Yeah. Yes. But like just to get the different, you know, response from people, like what songs they like and get different feedback. I mean, we don't give a shit anyway. We're going to play what we want. But I mean, it kind of helps us get an idea of what people are responding to. So.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's exciting.
It is. Yeah. I love it. Mm-hmm. And so we do have one final game-ish thing. And so do we want to do each person with their own individual one, or do we want to do each person has to answer one question? We do it differently like every time.
I like.
So.
I have quite a couple. I have them for everybody, actually.
Okay.
So however,
okay.
I didn't pick any. I'm not picking on anyone in particular, but we're just
okay.
Start how
you have
start.
More than me. So. So we can
go
back and forth and then, yeah.
Get Kevin in on the mix.
I know he likes to answer them too.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So the first one I have, I actually kind of want to know about everybody because I feel like they may have different answers.
Yeah. Yes.
But this is, I ask this to everybody that comes through because I just think it's really interesting and it says a lot about you personally. So every one of you guys, I'd like to know, what is your favorite decade in the past?
90s.
90s for Joe.
I'm going to go with double zeros.
2000s.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
I would go with the 60s.
Okay.
Very diverse
and a theor
answers.
I'd go with the 80s just because when I was growing up, it was the funnest time of my life. And it's when I discovered all the music.
Mm-hmm.
And that's when you were born and it's your birthday.
Yeah.
Yeah, awesome.
That is awesome.
I'm with you.
That's
with
the
you.
First time that every single
so
person has answered differently.
Differently. That makes it really neat. That
typically, the whole band is like, the 90s. And we're like, okay. No, but that's really cool. And I didn't expect you to say the 90s because you don't own a TV. Joe, I'm looking past.
That's when
John.
He had a TV last.
Yeah,
was the
90s. I had a TV in the 90s.
I think that kind of explains a little bit how you guys can come out with so much different types of music and diversity in each album. I think that explains a lot, just that answer with the different decades. I think that's cool. That's a really good... mixture you guys have going on. Really, really different. Mm-hmm. I like it.
And that explains, you know, some of the influences. You guys have influences back from the Beatles to, you know, to Stone Temple Pilots to Nirvana to Metallica. I almost said Smetallica. I was going to say Black Sabbath.
Black Sabbath. He has on there Led Zeppelin. Loving that.
So, yeah, that totally explains it. It's just cool that every single one of you had a different answer. So it makes me happy. It's very rare. So go ahead with one of yours.
Favorite scary movie? I'll start with Erin.
Oh, he's over
favorite
there.
Scary movie.
Favorite scary movie, and then I'm going to come back to the band here.
Once Upon a Time in a Faraway Land. favorite scary movie, I think, would probably be Aliens 2.
That's the second one.
The second one.
And just because, you know, it was the only movie where we actually had a bit of a chance. Game over, man.
Game over. I love that movie so much. So to who next?
Joe.
You have to point to people.
Joe.
Yeah, this is tough for me. I don't really watch scary movies. Does Gremlins count?
It does. Yeah. It totally counts. That movie was scary as shit when I was a kid. And I just said shit. Breaking me in. Okay. What about John?
If I had to think about like my favorite scary movie, it would be The Shining.
Yes.
But if I had to think about a movie that really scared me and kind of just scared me at that point in time would be like, don't laugh, but Scream. I was only 10 when that came out.
That's a good
movie.
When
you're,
and everywhere I went, I just felt like I was going to get stabbed, man.
No, that's a great movie.
It is a good answer.
No judgment. I love Scream.
I like tough one, you know, tied up, stabbed to death.
It was. And it was a new kind of horror movie at the time. They weren't making meta movies yet, and so it was a different genre. I totally understand.
Yeah.
Totally get it.
Red Rum.
Thanks,
Kev. Oh, we're going to be doing this.
That's just what he decides to interject. Red Rum.
Is that a movie or are we doing this in the mirror later?
Red Rum is just actually scary.
I'm
scared of Red Rum.
Yes. The Shining is actually terrifying, and I love that movie also. Who is it to next? There's many people here.
Randy.
The blood and guts doesn't scare me. Like that type of stuff, like the stuff that could actually happen. There was a movie in the 80s called The Hitcher.
Ooh.
About a guy that was a hitchhiker. And that, like, that's the type of stuff that can really happen.
Right.
Thomas Howell.
Yeah. That's like a horror movie for me. That other stuff, the vampires, it's nothing.
Right. It's not based in reality.
Is that? Right. So I bet you never hitchhiked before then.
No.
You never will either.
No, I won't pick one up either.
Okay. Hitchhiker. That makes more sense. Like the hitcher. Like he loads hitchhikers. On the trailer. He's on the side of the car.
Slides it in.
You always hit your knee right on the corner of it. The hitcher.
Joe's never going to feed Gizmo after midnight. Athir, what's your favorite scary movie or scariest movie I met? Not favorite, but what scares you the most movie?
I would have to say the original Exorcist.
Oh, my God. It's mine.
That shit was fucking satanic, man.
Scary.
I scared the shit out of me when I was a kid.
Yeah, it still does.
It was just that, I think.
Yeah, I don't like those possession type movies. All right, now I'm just going to go. You got some more? Because I'm going to do my rest in the circle.
Okay. Do you want Kevin to answer yours?
Yeah, I actually do want Kevin to answer. Because I'm going to sit circles behind me. Please, your favorite scary movie.
I that's why I said Red Rum.
Is it a movie that is actually...
No, it's
The Shining. It's a reference
to The Shining. Okay, yeah.
I would say The Shining, but also I agree with the theory. The Exorcist was a pretty twisted shit with the television.
That movie scarred me. I wouldn't watch scary movies for 5 years, at least.
I'm sad that I didn't experience The Exorcist the way that people did when it came out, because I think it's the most boring fucking movie.
Really?
It's not scary because I saw it as an adult now. But people who saw it when it came out and they were little are scarred. And to me, it's like, I don't even want to watch it. It's on and I'm like, flip. Like, it's so boring to me.
Like, even when her head's turning around?
Yes, because it's so... The effects don't match up.
Oh, because the effects aren't
now
back then are a little bit different than they are nowadays.
The effects don't hold up the way that... I mean, some effects do hold up, but those effects don't hold up.
Like Alien.
Like, some of the effects do and don't in there. But, I mean...
The latest in claymation technology.
Right. So, I don't know. The Exorcist never got to me. But The Shining, though, that was done a whole other way.
My favorite decade was the 70s, since you didn't ask me.
Oh, I'm sorry, Kev.
The 70s?
I didn't ask Erin either, to be fair.
The 70s were the best.
For you, in the 70s, like, music-wise, or for you personally?
Everything.
I know. I've heard so many great stories from her.
Yeah, everything. The 70s ruled.
And you experienced a lot.
Me too. We're probably the same age.
I would have liked to be alive in the 70s. I was only alive about a month and a half.
I would like to live in the year 3477.
They say.
Anyone else listening to the podcast should know exactly what I'm talking
about.
They're
going to hear this.
3477.
Oh, boy.
I'm going to have to Google this later.
I don't know.
Do you want to do fast, rapid fire and start off?
Sure. Well,
so we go around in a circle?
The next few are actually music related. So I'll
Mine
ask
aren't.
The
okay.
last, because I only have two more. I didn't
I
do enough open. Homework here on my
no,
rapid
you're good.
Fire. I got
a couple extra.
Okay, good. Awesome. Awesome. And so I kind of want to know, maybe all of you can answer this because you've been in a band together for so long, but what is the favorite stage you've ever played? Or maybe it's not even with this band, but it might
the
be the Fillmore because we were talking about that.
Yeah, it's a nice big stage.
Mm-hmm.
The problem is, though, it's so big that it's kind of overwhelming.
Right.
But
we stood this
it's
close.
Still awesome.
It's bigger behind the curtain than it is in front of the curtain.
Yeah.
And then when you get up there, you're like, you can't see the audience.
No, you can't.
So you're like,
we stood this close when we played.
Why?
No, I'm just joking.
Oh, I was like, what?
No, yeah. There's, you know, funner stages when there's people right up next to you and you can see their faces and,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Because some people it helps to be able to interact with the audience like that, but some people maybe have some stage fright and they kind of want to kind of distance themselves, maybe stare off to one certain spot when they're performing. It just depends on the level of comfortableness you have on the stage is what I would think.
Yeah.
And I'm not even, I'm a performer as a DJ, but I'm not, as a band, I could kind of imagine that.
Mm-hmm. The bigger the stage, the more intimidating. Even
definitely.
If you can't see the audience, I mean, mm-hmm. it's still definitely the most intimidating.
That's yeah. I totally agree.
St. Andrews is a good stage, too.
Which one?
St. Andrews.
Oh, St. Andrews. I've actually never been there.
St. Andrews is probably my favorite, too.
Yeah.
Really?
I think it's the perfect size. Everybody can see.
Right.
I like the Crowfoot better.
That was great.
Crowfoot. Yeah, you guys, I did see that you played at the Crowfoot.
We're always talking about the Crowfoot. We need sponsorship from the Crowfoot.
I haven't played there yet, so.
I don't like their stage.
But something's to be said for playing up close with, like, the shelter is just the people are right here.
Right. Is it a small stage?
Yeah.
I'll be at the shelter tomorrow seeing Dorothy. I'm very excited.
It's
Wizard of Oz stuff?
Nope.
Oh, okay.
It's a band called Dorothy. She's hot as hell.
Hmm.
Yeah, so I don't know. So it just depends. I guess that's why I said, like, maybe you can answer as a band and maybe you can answer separately. But that's, yeah, favorite stage depends. It has a lot of variables.
Yeah, it definitely.
Favorites for different reasons. Yeah. Because sometimes a small stage is better and sometimes a big stage is better. So, yeah, that one was, I guess, more of a conversation than a question.
Okay, mine is going to, I'm just going to go around.
That's fine. Go ahead.
Okay, I'll start with Kevin. Most disgusting thing someone can do in public.
Ew.
Fifth.
The most disgusting thing someone can do in public.
Yes.
Pick your nose.
That's what I was going to say.
Erin says pick your nose. Erin, GTV.
Okay, this is nasty. witnessing someone trimming their toenails or fingernails in public.
Especially at a restaurant.
I don't understand. Well, I mean, I don't know. I just don't think that's a thing. I just stood there in awe. But yeah.
Yeah, that's gross.
It happens. I would
Am I alone in that? Is that
no,
odd?
That's disgusting.
No, that's gross. Right?
Joe, what's the most disgusting for you?
I would say somebody taking a dump or something like that.
Like out in the open?
Yeah, I mean, you think about like a bum would have to poop somewhere, so where does he go? He's got to go in public. That would be pretty gross.
Wendy's or Tim Hortons? I get you. You're totally right. Okay, let's go. Keep going. We'll go around this way.
All right, I'm going to say... licking your fork.
Licking your fork?
In a restaurant.
You have to lick it.
Yeah, when there's no food on it, you lick your fork clean.
Oh.
Yeah, I knew someone who does that.
Does it bother you?
Yeah, it's like there's food on your plate. It's not your fork. Do what you need to do.
Wait, someone else's fork? You do that?
Wait, somebody else's fork?
No, like when you're eating and then, you know, you're like...
Like, okay, like if done eating and there's still food on the fork, bro, you know I'm going to try to get the rest of that food.
I was literally horrified. Listen, I looked over at you and I thought he was saying, when you go around, you know, the table licking other people's forks when there's no food.
No.
I can get that. I can see if someone licked a plate, like,
see, I won't do that.
No?
I think that's grosser than the fork.
Okay, well,
that's
sometimes
funny.
You're just hungry.
I don't, because more people don't put the plate in their mouth.
More people put the fork in their mouth.
Yeah, but your fork touches the plate.
Yeah. It's all...
That's really funny.
Wait, just so that we're clear, it is your own fork, though, right? I mean, it's not other people's fork.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it was just there, though, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, I was just wanted to clarify.
I'm going to continue to do that, because I'm going to gross people out like you all the time.
Randy.
So, everyone, please send Erin your dirty forks.
Rudest thing.
I love it.
Mostly, people are rude drivers.
Yes.
I almost fought an old man today, and you don't want to fight an old man.
No.
Because... if you beat an old man, they're like, you hurt an old man. And then if you lose to an old man, and then you're like, you lost
There's
to an
no
old
winning
man.
And beating an old man.
It's a lose-lose.
So
yeah, lose-lose situation.
I didn't even do anything wrong. But drivers.
Drivers.
Rude drivers.
They disgust you.
They disgust me, too.
Yeah, I get it.
Athir, birthday boy.
I guess watching someone puke in front of you.
Puking's pretty disgusting. Yeah, you do in public.
It's like a kid.
No matter who it is.
Mm.
That's gross.
And from that gross question.
But I mean, there's other things, but I can't say.
From that gross question, can I go counterclockwise real quick?
Yeah.
Favorite junk food? This should be fast.
Twizzlers.
What about you?
A Athir.
Sour candy. Sour licorice.
That's good.
Sour straws.
Twizzlers are mine.
Popcorn.
Popcorn, Joe.
That birthday cake that's sitting out.
Yeah. Oh, we're going to eat that.
It's almost birthday cake time.
AGTV?
Snickers all day.
Erin?
Oh, God, so many things.
What?
It depends on my mood because sometimes chocolate and sometimes sour.
I know. I'm both, that way, too.
I don't know. It depends on the
candy.
Day.
Candy.
Yep, candy.
You must only pick one.
Candy is candy.
One answer or die.
I can't do it. You know what I'm going to say? I'm going to say snowballs.
Ooh.
I love those little tiny cake dudes.
I like cake pops. Kevin, what do you like?
As he's eating.
He's eating it right now.
What are you eating right
What's
now?
Your favorite junk food?
He's eating the cake.
Are you
Is he eating the cake?
I'm eating Jimmy John's jalapeno chips.
We were all about
he likes the jalapeno cruncher chips, right?
We were talking tech talk, Phil and I.
Well, we just got upset because
I didn't know how, because I had this big glare in the window. I haven't asked Phil any of these questions. Phil, what's your favorite junk food?
We can't hear him, though. He doesn't have a mic.
Oh, okay.
I can give him a mic.
He can vicariously live through Kevin's mic.
He doesn't want a mic.
He doesn't. He really doesn't.
Just shout him out like you're on the planet, Sexy Phil.
Sexy Phil is very awesome.
Favorite junk food used to be Oreos until they moved to Mexico, and then I can't eat a Mexican Oreo.
Wait a minute. What's wrong with Mexican
this is why,
Oreos?
This is why Phil doesn't have a mic.
I think that...
I didn't say that. Phil said that. I was trying to.
I know. That's why.
Okay. I want to ask a relevant question. Can
yes,
I?
Please. Oh, we like yes. questions.
I want to ask a question.
Okay.
This is a first.
Out
yes.
Of, out of all four of the songs we played, which one do you like best, Erin? One, two, three, or four?
Four of the
all f-
the songs that we played.
Out of the songs
tonight.
We played, I'm most familiar with one and three. One because I feel like Kevin was working on it. Or you were working on it while I was here or something.
Oh, okay.
So I'm trying not to let that.
So your favorite was?
I.
You got a drum roll, dude.
Right. Right.
They were all good, right?
They were all awesome. They were all awesome. I want to pick two or four because I don't want to be.
We like it. We like number one here in the tech crew department.
Yeah, I really liked number one, but I actually think I'm going to go with number two. Time for Living. I remember really digging that while we were like.
I know for sure what I like the most, but see what it is inside here. I can't hear when you're singing. I can only hear. No. So after when I look back at the videos, I'm like, oh my goodness. And then I can hear it after. But I could definitely tell that the last song you played, Bright Silver Lights, I really loved that song a lot. I actually liked all the songs, to be honest with you. And I've seen a lot more of your music from before on YouTube as well. And so I really think overall everything I've seen has been solid. But I would say number four. But when we go back and then they... master the vid like the sound and the videos, and I look back at it, I'm like, oh my goodness, it's just such a different of what I'm hearing, which is no vocals. And by the way, you guys have great voices. Thanks. Wonderful.
Aaron.
They go well together.
I
really
like the last one.
Yes.
Yeah, I like the last one the best.
Yeah, the one was pretty pretty. Cool. Yeah. That was Bright Silver Lights, right?
Yeah.
That I really like that.
And I have one more music question too. Mm-hmm. And it's again, you can because I know you guys have. When I asked you before we got on the air, you've done albums both digitally and analogically. That's not a word, but you know what I'm saying. What is the word I'm looking for there? And but I don't know what the word is.
Analog.
It's just analog. Yeah.
It's just analog. Digitally or analog. It just
seems
wrong.
You've done both digital and analog recordings.
Yeah,
there you go.
There we go. Thank you, AGTV. So I guess which do you prefer? I mean, I know there's like a rawness about the analog way, but it's so much easier digitally. I just wanted to know like which you guys
even
prefer.
When we did the analog, we still went digital on some of the tracks as well. So we didn't have just a straight analog record.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, it's a different, I think for different songs, analog is better, but for other songs, digital is better. So I don't know.
It sounds different. It really still relies a lot on the mix, you know, because we've done two different analog type. And they both sounded differently.
There's definitely a feeling to the analog that isn't in digital. And for some music, it just brings it out and brings it together.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've never been able to record in analog. So it's interesting for me to be able to, I don't know, pick people's brains about it, I guess. And I like that.
I think you have to do it once.
We have a 2-inch tape machine here at the sound shop, girl.
I know.
Just do a song and try it.
Right over here.
Just one song, maybe.
We should all do one of Kevin's songs.
Yeah, we should do that right now.
Right. Just yeah.
I'm down. I'm down.
You are. Yes. This is soft.
We need to re-record one of Wes Niles' songs. That's one of Kevin's old bands. If you're following along,
Kevin's
here.
Only ever been in one band in his whole life.
Okay, all right. Well,
that would
you
be
know.
The Wes Nile.
I don't know your entire life, Kevin. I only know like 80% of it.
We just sourced that for Wikipedia. So.
Yep.
Kevin Wesley Williams has only ever been in one band.
It's true. Only ever been in one band ever. And so, yeah, we're getting toward the end of the episode here. We're running about toward the end. So do you have one final question you want to ask?
No, I just want to make a statement. I'm reading through the pre-interview. I just want to say, I read over here that you guys write and record and share your musical creations to inspire others. And that's something that's real personal with me. And also because you love to play. So how does it feel to be able to do something that you love to do? What kind of feeling is that?
It's a good feeling to be able to do what you do, you know, and have fun doing it.
It is. It's almost like it's never a job. It's just...
Yeah, I mean, we do it for, you know, it's not full-time musicians, but we are, you know, we love it, so...
And that's good when you do what you love because it definitely shows in your music.
Mm-hmm.
Passion.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And do you guys want to say any final thoughts before we go?
Thanks, everybody, for watching.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thanks.
I love that, like, before you said thanks, there was, like, a squeak. It was like, I can't even redo what you just did, but it was wonderful. I thought
I'm going to make a song. It's like a beatbox.
I thought that there was, like, somebody letting air out of a balloon while you were speaking. I was like, what is that? Hi.
Awesome. So, once again, coreeffect.com is where they can find out most, and facebook.com, you can look them up. Mm-hmm. On YouTube, though, there's tons of stuff there. I was getting ready to that earlier.
Yeah,
and that there's lots of stuff there too as well. So mm-hmm. that was cool.
And earlier today on my Facebook, if you search Erin Accomando, good luck spelling that. I did share one of their music videos, one of their most recent videos. Coroner is the one that I shared, and so you guys can check that out. And maybe I'll even be smart and share that on the page too, because I didn't think about that at the time. But if you'd like to follow us,
we have this technology.
If you guys want to check us out anywhere except, you know, Facebook, which is probably where you're listening right now, you can find us at Twitter and Snapchat at MC Music Society, and also Instagram, where I post all the time, a couple times a week typically, at Motor City Music Society, because they let you have a whole lot of characters on Instagram, which I love.
Yeah, I do like that.
I love it a lot. And our next episode is going to be in 2 weeks from now, which I believe is March 6th. Again, I always forget to write the date down before I get here at this moment.
But we know who it is.
It is Maria Montoya. I have been friends with her for a little while, and I met her through the band Kaleido, which we're also trying to get on the show in just a few months. So yeah, tune in 2 weeks from today, which if you're listening live, that's 2 weeks, but
yeah.
I hope the date is March 6th. Will somebody confirm this for me while we're here? Somebody open up a calendar, because this is the one thing I always forget to write down.
I can open it up.
And I'm just not fast enough.
Well, you can look it up. Well, I just wanted to say about Sound Shop Studio. If you guys don't know where we're located, it is just north of Hall Road off of Gratiot. So that's kind of across the KFC. Very, very beautiful building. And you got Kevin Wesley Williams with West Mix.
Mm-hmm.
He does the mixing, recording, also Josh Ford. But if you want to get at us, you can come record for a good price. So message me. Also, we are offering karaoke parties for all occasions, where you can come in the studio, record CDs, bring your friends, bring food. It's just such a fun time. Message me. We'll get you here. Even if you want a tour, if you're a local musician, come on in and record. Just come on in for a tour. I'll meet you here. And it's a very fantastic place to be with some very great people. So I'm thanking you for watching. I just wanted to mention that about the studio, because everybody here is amazing, in my opinion. And I'm just happy to be here.
Thank you guys for having us on.
Oh, thank you guys for coming. That was like the next thing out of my mouth.
She's got the cat shirt on. She needs to say mouse once.
I did. My mouth is watering for the cake, and so I'm like salivating. Like, I'm so ready for the cake.
Okay, we're
still
going to eat the cake.
I know.
Are we eating the cake live?
Oh, that'd be funny. No, definitely not.
Cutting ceremony and like feed each other in the mouth.
Joe made some beers.
You made beers?
I got some beers I made.
You brew? Yeah. Do you brew beer?
I started to.
Awesome.
Oh my gosh. Yeah.
That's amazing. Can I have one?
I had no idea when you offered me a beer that was homemade beer. I let it go right in one ear and out the other.
Oh my gosh.
I'll be having a beer with my cake.
I will definitely take a beer. Yeah.
What a great hobby.
Do you have a name for your brewing company yet?
Cake beer.
Oh, it's not a company yet. It's just a project.
That's cool. Yeah.
That's really cool. That's like a fun hobby. Cake beer? Does it taste like cake, or do you have different flavors and different types of?
I don't have a cake beer yet.
Oh,
they're just making shit up.
No, I was making shit
yeah,
up.
Yeah, he was making.
Oh my, I'm so. Am
beer
I being
with
naive,
my cake.
But
you know what? You can stuff some frosting in that beer. It'll probably taste like a cake beer.
A cake and a beer.
Yeah, cake and
yum.
Beer.
Anyway, we digress. But that's really cool, Joe.
I
want to
wash down my
beer
with some cake.
So, yeah, I think that's a serious business venture in the future for you.
Oh, yeah.
Have some Joe Schmo beer. People be like, what?
Joe Bazooka beer.
Joe Bazooka?
Yeah. Do you know what Joe Bazooka is?
No, I don't. I'm sorry.
It's bubblegum.
It's
bubblegum that you get fun little comics in there.
I just thought it was called Bazooka.
Bazooka Joe.
Oh, I just thought it was called Bazooka.
Well, they might have changed it by now. They've got the pieces used to be big and yummy with good stuff, and now they're tiny.
I remember that. I just thought they were called Bazooka.
That's
anyway,
what happens. things get smaller as the times change.
Bob Surgot's here.
That's true. Oh, hi, Bob.
Surgot or Saget? Surgat, I'm happy with.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hi, Bob.
Hi, Brad.
Caught the very end of this episode. So I just want to thank the whole crew one more time. Phil Steuer is in the booth doing tech. AaronG TV was here on the mic and doing tech. Kevin Wesley Williams was on the booth duty, doing all the engineering. We had Core Effect here in studio, and you guys
awesome
rocked
guys.
It so hard. Thank you for being here.
Thanks.
And
thank you.
It was so much fun. Everybody check out coreeffect.com. And my name is Erin.
And I'm Tammy Lynn.
And this has been episode 4 of Motor City Music Society. Thank you guys so much. We will see you